On December 21, 2021, at 5 p.m. local time, a strong series of earthquakes began underneath the Geldingadalir volcano in Iceland. In the span of 22 hours since, more than 1,000 earthquakes have occurred, the largest of which was a magnitude 4.9. These earthquakes were unusually shallow and had a likely magmatic signature to them, indicating the movement of magma in the crust. At the same time, the harmonic tremor of this volcano dramatically spiked, reaching levels not seen since the volcano stopped erupting on September 18th. As a result, the Iceland Meteorological Service raised the alert level of the Krysuvik volcanic system, which Geldingadalir is a part of, from yellow to orange. So, will an eruption occur? What is likely to happen next? This video will answer these two questions and discuss the ongoing seismic unrest. For some context, the Geldingadalir volcano is located on the Reykjanes Peninsula in southwest Iceland, where it is 30 kilometers south-southwest of the capital Reykjavik and 20 kilometers southeast of the international airport. In this section of Iceland, the crust is slowly spreading apart to the northwest and southeast as the North American plate is separating from the Eurasian plate. Since there is a hotspot in the mantle underlying the country, the spreading points represent a path of least resistance, allowing for magma to intrude into these weak spots in the crust and erupt onto the surface. The Reykjanes Peninsula is thus filled with several volcanoes which trend in northeast-facing fissures, one of which happens to be Krysuvik. The 2021 eruption of Geldingadalir, which lasted from March 19th to September 18th, was the first to occur from this volcano since 1340 AD. Over the span of several months, a large lava field was constructed via a chain of several northeast-trending vents. Keeping this in mind, take a look at the distribution of earthquakes which have occurred in the last 24 hours. They also follow this geometry. In all likelihood, these earthquakes represent the movement of magma underneath Geldingadalir as it still contains a deep magma chamber. This magma chamber is located at a depth of approximately 12 to 15 kilometers and represents a sort of storage for molten rock underlying this volcano. On occasion, volumes of molten rock randomly travel either horizontally or vertically in what is termed an intrusion of magma. Based on the available evidence, it appears that a horizontal intrusion of magma, which is called a sill, is ongoing along a 7.5-kilometer-long stretch of land centered around Geldingadalir. Although earthquakes are seemingly appearing to get shallower and shallower over time, this does not yet necessarily indicate an imminent eruption. One way to determine if a vertical intrusion is occurring is to measure the amount of uplift in the ground, as much like a mole in a yard, it uplifts the ground above it. At the present, there still is not a sudden and dramatic uplift in the ground as would be expected for a vertical intrusion of magma. However, at two ground stations, which are marked on screen, there has been a slow uplift of 2 centimeters since November 15th. This indicates a potential slow-moving vertical intrusion of magma, but in my opinion is insufficient to generate an eruption at the present. Thus, we are in a situation similar to what was experienced on the peninsula in early March. An eruption could technically begin with very little warning around Geldingadalir, but it is far from a certainty. Unless the rate of ground deformation dramatically spikes, I would place the odds of a new eruption at around 15%. If a new eruption was to occur, it would most likely cause a resumption of lava output at one of Geldingadalir's vents, as these are already a natural path of least resistance. Here is a quick map of where a new eruption could begin based on the ongoing earthquake swarm. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.